Man, we back with another episode. Y'all boy, we see got Kelly Walk back with another episode with us, man. That boy been gone for about 2 weeks, man. What you been up to, man? What
come
you
on,
you been missing, bro. I ain't seen you, bro.
Yeah, I've been living life.
You know, yes, sir.
Had to get school right.
You listen, know. He told me he was gonna come in the bed and be a guest host, so we ain't seen that boy.
Bro, come on, now you playing.
Living, bro. Shit.
Doing his own thing. You can fuck, nigga.
I'm happy, bro. I'm just living life, bro.
Oh, he happy and shit. That's fucked up. We ain't happy on this bed. This an angry nigga podcast.
I'm just saying, bro.
Get
I'm
your
happy.
Mind right,
I'm
man.
Happy, bro. Life.
Why you happy?
Huh?
Why you happy?
That's too much right there.
That boy ain't.
You asked too many questions, but I ain't gonna lie to you.
I ain't gonna say it on the pod.
Fuck that shit, man. Tell the people, man. The people come to listen.
I'm not telling
that's
them.
Only one type of smile. You feel me? That's only one type. You feel me? You ought to know the deal.
We're gonna get into the podcast, man. I know, man. It's Quanta Cliff as always.
Come on, man.
Podcast, man. Listen, we talking about a man's mental today, man. You know, a lot of times people don't get into the mental things of a man. You feel me? Like, they don't know how a man handles certain situations. So we're gonna get in here and talk about that shit. First question, dude. How y'all boys feel about mental health?
I feel like mental health is it's a big thing in the new society.
Right.
Just with everything going on. Like, I never say I ain't went through anything on my mental health. Me, it was more like things not going my way when I was a freshman, when I first got here.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But I feel like mental health is a gateway to get to God. Mm-hmm. Like, I never say it's not important, but like me going through what I went through, I got closer with God. God was on me hard, testing me how strong I was. Yeah, I was weak at one point.
Mm-hmm.
But I ain't break. Yeah, I ain't break though. I'm still here.
Yeah.
I could have easily been at the crib, living the life I didn't want to live. But like mental health, like there's a lot of people I know who going through some serious things right now in life. And all my homeboy, my team, and them boy, I know they can come to me if they need advice just to stay strong. Especially as a black man in this world, we go through a lot of stuff. Especially like just with the everyday life of just being judged and things like that. But like as a man, just always make sure your mental health straight. But sometimes you gotta just push through it, dog. Honestly,
yeah. Everything gonna be sweet and pretty.
Yeah, right?
You gotta push through sometimes.
See, for me, mental health is everything.
Yeah.
Mental health is your. You can't get up, go to work without having mental health. You can't get up, go to class, get up in the morning. You know what I'm saying? Just like what he said, God. God got to be included in your mental health as well. You know what I'm saying? Also, your mental health. Okay, let me see how I'm going to say it. So, when wrong move, if your mental health is off, it could fuck up the rest of your life. You know what I'm saying? Just say, okay, somebody take your parking spot, something like
that.
He get out of the car yelling,
bad
snapping.
Day.
A bad day. Next thing you know, you done uphold. You done blew
killed the nigga by the parking
spot. You
feel
me? By the parking spot, by nothing. Because you not right up here. You know what I'm saying? So mental health is everything. It helps you delegate through life.
Yeah.
Make decisions. Always make sure it's on point. Especially being black.
Definitely. Mental health is very important. But like I see, I got a mental health matters. But I seen this jacket. I said, but I got to buy that. I bought three of them. I got a red, blue, and a gray one. I like mental health matters. Like, it tell you mental health matters. Like, I wear it. When people see it, mental health matters. One day I may walk around, people look at my shirt, mental health matters. You be like, it's somebody, like, they don't know me, but they might be like, oh, you might care. You feel me?
Uh-huh.
Like, somebody, you don't know what type of day can happen, but, like, mental health is very important to me. Like, I battle my mental health every day, like, with football. Uh-huh. Like, bro said, sometimes things will go my way. Sometimes, like, life, period. Life gonna test you. Like you say, God put you through tests to see where you at. You feel me? So, mental health is very important to me.
Sure.
But we gonna get into it, though. First question, why do men tend to put their feelings to the side to protect others? Whether it be relationships, not telling people how they really feel, not telling people the truth, like your homeboy come ask you not to tell people the truth, why do men tend to put their feelings to the side for others, to protect other feelings?
For me in this situation, that's a great question.
That is a good question.
I'm gonna wait for the relationship side. For the homeboys, I don't do it with my homeboys.
Yeah.
As a black man,
I was just gonna say that.
I can't sit there and not tell him the truth. Uh-huh. Yeah. By some over feelings. Like my homeboy, like bro, me and him go at it all the time. My roommate, my boys, we go at it all the time. Yeah. Like he may not like it, I might not like it. But I gotta tell the truth in that situation.
For sure.
I feel like as a man, when you like the man the backbone. Like he gotta be the backbone. He gotta be able to take certain things without an effect. And like, if a man really ran off his emotion, that's a dangerous man. And I had people around me who was like that for real. And I had to get
home. Definitely.
Like, man, you can't be ran by your emotion.
Now how you feel?
I ain't the type of person to say, oh yeah, just fuck my feelings, things like that. I'm human. Like I got emotions, things like that. But like, when you care about somebody, you ain't trying to hurt them for real. Mistakes happen, but certain mistakes you can't just forget about it. That can go both ways. Men, women, certain mistakes you can't just forget.
Mm-hmm. So you right.
It's something ain't an easy question to say. I ain't gonna do nothing to put myself in the fuck situation. I ain't gonna do that. But like if you is, you gotta just take what comes with it. If you're gonna be honest about it. Honestly.
Yeah. Okay. That's a great question, but for me, honestly, I don't really put nobody feelings I could say before mine or how I'm feeling. I'm always gonna tell my homeboy the truth about everything, even if he in the wrong. Now it's different if we in front of people.
Yeah.
I never put my homeboy, you feel
on
me?
Blast, yeah.
Bro, hell no.
Never put him on blast. We always put that behind closed doors, but you feel me? So but besides that, in a relationship, I'm my feeling I'm putting my feelings first. Period. I'm gonna let you know how I'm feeling, what I'm thinking. If you can't get hip to that, then we can't be together. But homeboy wise, I'm always being straight up with them, period. Ain't no other way to be.
Yeah. Shit, with me, I feel like I'm just starting to learn like to put my feelings first. Like for a long time I was like, man, I'ma say this or say that so they won't feel that type of way, won't feel the type of way. Like I'm always like, I'm a big believer, like I don't want nobody to feel bad. Like I don't like making people feel bad, making people feel down. So if I feel a certain way about something, I know it's gonna affect their feelings. Like, I'm gonna be like, nah, blah, blah, blah. Like, but like he did say, my homeboys, like, them two niggas,
yeah.
I'm gonna tell them nigga, blood raw, man, hell nah, cuz you tripping. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Whatever can it be. But like, with my female friends or relationships, like, I tend to like,
try to maneuver,
yeah. Like, yeah. Be like, nah, yeah, I mean, yeah, but nah. Like, you feel me? I try to sugarcoat it.
Uh-huh,
basically, nah, I try to sugarcoat it to protect their feelings, cause I don't want them to be like, well, blah, 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 I start crying. I hate that crying shit. I hate all that shit. That shit blows me. But so, like, but now I'm starting to learn, like, put your feelings first. Like,
nah, definitely.
And it's, and women don't agree with it, or it can be, like, relationship. Why women don't agree with it most times, but as a man, bro, like, you can't just sit back and let your feelings just be ran over.
Exactly.
Everybody got feelings, too. Like, and people die by, people die by not getting their feelings, too. Like, you let it build up. You'll end up
bad
shit'll happen.
Terrible shit'll happen.
I'm just not learning. Like, I told, like, literally told both of them, boy, I said, bro, I'm in the place, darn, but I'm putting myself first.
No,
like,
you got
I'm
to.
I'm finding my peace, my own self love. Like, nah, I'm not really focusing on other stuff. Like, I'm focused on me right now. You feel me? I told them boys that.
Uh-huh.
God. So, like, but, like, that'll rub women the wrong way, though. But, like, it just depends on who you're dealing with. Like, and they say they understand, but they really
don't understand. They really don't.
Understand it because they feel like you said, men is the backbone, so we're not supposed to have no feelings to what we feeling like, oh, we can't shut down. Like, bro, sometimes I shut down, I be in a room to myself. Like, bro, like, sometimes I don't want to talk to nobody. Sometimes I just want to be to myself, working on myself, like, getting myself right. Like, I feel like right now, I can't really truly give out what I need to give out because if I'm not get good with myself, you feel what I'm saying?
Like, you're right.
I'm always putting on, showing people this, but in the reality is that, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
So I feel like now I'm learning, like, put your feelings first, like, tell people the truth.
You're
like,
definitely right.
Don't be trying to maneuver or sugarcoat anything with nobody because they're not moving or sugarcoat anything with you.
I was just finna say that. When they doing wrong, boy, they ain't trying to move a certain way, but with you, when you do it, it's you trying to duck it.
Yeah.
Man, bro.
Yeah,
nah. Treat people how they treat you.
Yeah, for real.
Period, boy. Nah, I promise you.
I'm realizing, but don't hold your words for nobody, but don't hold your feelings for nobody, like, because your feelings matter just as much as theirs, bro. Like,
I promise you.
Holding it in, I'll make your ass.
I'm telling you, it's going to make you.
And then it'll be little things that make you just go crazy, like that relationship, anybody, like your friends, homeboy, homegirls, like, it'd be something little. You'd be like, bro, yo, dumbass, like, yo. he'll come off like, damn, nigga, you been feeling like this? Yo. Instead of just telling him, you feel me? Instead of just telling him when, really, when the shit really happened. Built up shit. And then it's different now, but when you hold it in, you'll lose friendship, relationship, all that, because you just held it in to that point.
You ain't lying.
I start fucking with somebody like that for real.
Yeah, I'm telling you, that's how it be.
Dog said some crazy. I'm like, damn, the whole time.
Like, you been feeling like this, but instead of keeping it a buck at the beginning.
Everybody make sure I get drunk.
You feel me? It's coming
real,
out.
Real man, shit
fuck
coming
that
out.
Nigga, you know how I feel it. No, yeah,
come on, man. Nah. Nigga, what we talking about?
Yeah.
Hey, that's crazy.
Nah, for real though.
Next question, y'all boys. How would you rank the following of importance? Family, career, and love life. And give me a reason why.
All right. For we all men on here, so like, I'm talking from a man perspective.
Men.
Family.
Okay. Yeah.
Number one. Me, I'm a family man. I can't deal with nobody who ain't really. Like, not really into their family. Like, just like, not saying, if you got a small family, I can't control that. Right. But, like, I'm a family person. Like, I got a big family, great support system on both sides, my mom and my dad's side.
Uh-huh.
So, family first. Man, I feel like career, because, like, I feel like if you go out there chasing for a woman,
you're going to lose yourself.
Yeah. Women be like, nah, women know the truth. They like a man who.
Got this shit together.
And then, like,
especially the older, like, later in life. Right now.
You gotta have something going on, but, like, you ain't gotta have life figured out. If a woman tell you, I want you all up on me, woman, that's a lie.
That's a fucking lie.
Years old, me trying to get my life together and just trying to see what I'm gonna be doing after this football stuff is my biggest purpose. After my family. And love, like, I feel like that should come while you're getting your purpose. Like, what you finna do with your life? You may meet somebody at this job, meet somebody in school, boom, boom, boom. Like, that's really the order for me.
See, really, same thing with me. Family, family, career, and love life.
Yeah.
Big family, man. You know what I'm saying? I love my family to death, so that's always gonna come first. Career, that's always gonna come second. You feel me? Because money is how the world runs. Yeah, you can't do shit without money.
Yeah.
People look at you crazy if you ain't got no money.
Nah, for real.
It's people on the street, they don't have no money. That's why we look at them crazy. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it's that nah, simple. Real shit, you feel me? But love life, third. It got to come third, because women, if you put your career, I mean, if you put your woman before your career,
She going to leave you.
Because you... You know what I'm saying? It's that simple. Yeah, you're providing nothing for her.
Yeah, you're providing.
How could you be a protector when you can't even protect the house over our head? You know what I'm saying?
You all under her.
You all under women.
You at the crib.
Come on, nah. That ain't gonna never work. Oh, I got a side question. Would y'all be okay with y'all woman making more than y'all?
Hell yeah.
You asked this already.
Oh, I did? Okay.
See, sure.
Okay, I'm
last episode.
Okay.
Who, me?
He said that he's already said his stepmama the bread.
Oh, okay, you did say that. See, okay.
Bullshit.
Yeah, I'm playing.
Like, he be getting off track now.
I'm playing.
I don't have a problem with that. I know what I got. She gonna know.
Let me answer, man. So, rank the following support, family, career, love. Like, me, I'm gonna flip. I ain't gonna lie. Career is gonna be first for me.
Okay.
Because I feel like, As long as I got, like I said, I've been putting me first. You feel me? If I got my career, I feel like everything else gonna fall in line. Like I'm doing what I love to do. Whether it be football, whether it be owning businesses, whether it be whatever case. As long as I'm doing what I love to do, I'll be happy every day because I'm doing what I love to do. Second, family, of course. Like, even though sometimes family could be your worst enemy, but at the end of the day, they always gonna be your family. Like, you can't change.
Nah, definitely.
The people God put on this earth to be your family. Family gonna always be your family. Blood, whatever the case may be. Like, and you're gonna make new family. Like, I consider Deuce and Cliff family. You feel me? Like, family argue, family fight. But sometimes family is not right. Shit.
Nah,
like,
for real.
But, and then love life. Shit. I mean, if I can't find a way to love my family, deal with my family, how can I find a way to deal with
a person that I don't know, that I don't even,
you know, feel me? Like,
you ain't fucking lying.
Y'all gonna have your ups and downs with the love life situation. Like, and if you ain't had no family to teach you, like, it's gonna be like this sometimes, and you still find a way to love them. How can I do like this with a woman and still find a way to love her? You know what I'm saying?
You're right.
I'm off kilter. So definitely career, family, then love life. Because I feel like my career, straight, my life going to a trajectory. Family always going to be like this. You feel me? Your little life probably gonna be like this sometimes. Rare crazy, it's always like this. So that's how I feel. Third question. Do y'all boys believe in second chances with relationships? Football shit, like people done seen people quit on us all the time. Shit, football. Like, do y'all believe in second chances? Period. With life. Period.
Second chances, as far as I just thought I would relationships. It ain't no, no. That's a lie. Only thing I wouldn't, as long as it's not infidelity.
Right.
Second chances can always, you know what I'm saying. As long as it's not that, I don't see why. People work past shit all the time. Yeah. Married people
about
work
to
past
say married,
something.
Like,
so
yeah,
I know me and whoever I'm with can work past it. But as far as with friends, yeah, say it really all depends on the scenario. Yeah, it really all depends on the scenario. Like a scenario, if my homeboy filing out in front of some hoes, we could talk about it. But I'm always gonna move a little.
Yeah, different. You don't. Y'all know how you act now.
Come on, it's literally all depends on the situation. Yeah. But as far as relationships, depends. Friends. Depends, family depends. Depends on the situation with me. But y'all,
I feel like I believe in second chances. Cause like with God, shit,
God, yeah, second chances.
We do a lot of things that God don't like. I'm a big believer in God. Got a lot of faith in God, like things like that. I ain't no second chance when it comes to football. Like, I believe in second chance. Me myself, like, I always taught myself to go get it, mm-hmm. try to get it the first way. But it's people who I done met, my boy, we locked in for real, who are second chance. So how I can say, I don't believe in second chances. I want to meet them boys. If them boys, what? If they ain't get second chance. All my boys D-line, like, it's a brotherhood. But, like, them boys went to different schools. So, like, if they ain't get no second chance, I probably would have met them. And my life would be totally different. Like, connections. I'm big on connections and stuff like that. Uh-huh. And then, like, relationships. Like he said, like, it's certain things with a respect level. Like, it's how you go about things. Like, I had to change my mindset. Me, back like 2 months ago, oh no. Nah. Okay, I had the same conversation with my stepmama. Like, I'm for real, like on some second chance. I was me arrogant, like, nah, man, fuck all that. No. But at the same time, bro, people are human, bro.
Yep.
Not saying, oh, I'm giving you a pass for what you did. But at the same time, people are human. Uh-huh. What if you did something? Like, you always got to flip. You always got to flip by what you did it. You got to flip.
So if somebody murdered your mama, a close relative of yours,
right?
Yeah,
do you believe they deserve a second chance?
But he wouldn't really like, get an opportunity to get that bit type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you feel me? I'm trying to Swiss cheese me a nigga ass first quarter. First quarter.
What you mean? What I mean?
You second chance at life to get out of jail or stuff like that?
Yeah.
I don't believe in the death penalty. That's basically what you're saying.
I say free.
I am, but I would be the dependent on that situation.
You feel me? I say free.
I understand what you're saying, but I'm saying
free that boy.
I understand.
Free that boy. Free that boy. Nah, for real.
You're dependent, John. You're taking a life for life, bro.
Nah, man, for real.
You don't
win. In that situation, I would be dependent.
Come on,
just ask my own question.
I don't even want that boy
you
a lot.
Nice. He's so fucking nice.
Free is
the truth, bro.
But I'm gonna go ahead and ask the question. Bro. Do I believe in second chances? I definitely believe in second chances. Cause I feel like the boy said, like, even with the infidelity thing, what it can be like, I feel like people young, people make mistakes. Like, it depends on what age. I mean, I don't know. I just feel like people be people and people make mistakes. Now, people got to learn. Like, you got to learn from your mistakes. You got to learn how to operate and go through things, right? But, like, what J. Cole said in the song, he was like, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice.
That's what I'm okay.
Fool me
I'm
twice. Fool
my
me
fault.
Twice, shame on me. Fool me three times, then that shit just, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I do believe in second chances, though. Like, with anything, like, you only getting two though with me for sure. Like,
nah, for sure.
First time, okay, you made a mistake, blah blah blah. Second time it's like, bro, you doing it again. Like, ain't no reason to keep trying, you know what I'm saying?
And with me, it's like, okay, an example of like a relationship.
Yeah.
I wouldn't respect my woman if she took me back after I cheated. Cause it's like, bitch, have some self love.
But You don't gotta understand, like,
he right, bro.
I hear what y'all saying, but what type of, how can you say she ain't got no self love when she done gave? You gotta check this out. Yo. Say if you and your girl in a really like real deal committed relationship, whatever can it be, she done really gave you her all. Like, she not really trying to start, like,
nah,
you might have cheated, but what type of boyfriend were you?
Nah, you right. I understand.
What type of boyfriend were you? Like, well, actually,
we on the same page.
Answer. What type of boyfriend? Like, were you?
What you mean?
Like, if were you cheating and you were beating on her, blah blah blah, doing all this? No, for real. No, for real.
Nah.
Was you calling out her name? Was you disrespecting her? Like, bro. Like, so what type of boyfriend was you cheating on her and still treating her like? No, for real. Think about this. No. I'm not.
Hold on. I'm saying.
No, listen. Let me finish. So, were you the type of boyfriend? You were cheating on her, but you were still cheating, right? Still getting anything she want. You never let that shit come to the house until you got caught.
Yeah.
So what the fuck? Hey, listen though. But nah, you gotta think. In a man's perspective, like a woman's perspective, how can you tell her just to break? Like, okay, infidelity is a big ass thing. Don't get it twisted. Don't get it wrong. Nah, that shit is wrong. You're not supposed to do that shit. But how can you sit here and say she don't have no self love for herself when she how she ain't got no self love? But you would you rather her? Would you rather her not take you back and go fuck 1,000 niggas? Then you're going to sit there and be, no. Listen. No, check me out. Dude, let me finish. Then she going to be, then she going to be a hoe. She going to be a slut. Which one, Cole?
Right.
Which one?
I understand. Dude,
you real. But you hear what I'm saying?
I understand.
Be real, though. You talking about she ain't got no self-love, but if vice versa, listen, you going to say she ain't got no self-love by going to sport herself, let her be fucking everybody. You going to say
But I'm saying for me personally, go out and step out on you, if you just welcome me back.
No, I'm not saying she welcome you back.
There you go. See,
what I'm saying. I'm not saying.
If you work your way back,
yeah. If you work your way back, and prove that's different. It's a step by step program. Then y'all get that, bro. But her just working you back. Yeah, she probably ain't got no solution. She don't give a fuck. She probably cheating on you too.
Yeah, that's what I couldn't. It just,
in the back of his mind, he'll like,
you feel me? If she's doing something, she just
let you right back in. You cheat the next day, y'all fucking again. Nigga, she been cheating on you too.
Nah, you right.
Because the way you said you was like, she had no self love. But you're going to say she ain't got no self love.
If she cheated on me, I would never even consider taking her back.
Right or wrong. For a man and woman.
You know that, bro.
You know that. Nigga, you done said that plenty of times.
You know that.
Hold on.
So you ain't never.
I have, but dude, I'm saying. Not, come on, I'm saying.
Now you contradicting yourself.
So we saying.
Bro, you contradicting yourself.
We saying.
You, okay, bro, you woman, out of her, you say for a woman to be is being conquered. It's being conquered.
It's different.
So of course you wouldn't take her back if she cheated on you because she's being conquered by another man.
I understand what you're saying.
That's what I'm
saying. I can't
get behind it though.
This is what we're saying. We ain't saying, oh, 2 weeks later.
Yeah, no. Y'all done stopped talking, all this blah blah blah, then y'all reconnect on some.
Yeah,
you know what
time
saying?
Heals everything. It really depends
but
how long
you talking about. You talking about the next day? It's the next day she fucking you, nigga. Yes, she don't have no self love because she been fucking on another nigga the whole time y'all together.
You right? It just depends. It really depends, girl. It depends. It honestly depends, girl. It do.
It don't depend. It depends on. Like, bro, because at the end of the day, you still gonna be like, she ain't got no self love, whether she take you back or whether she go fuck 1,000 niggas.
Yeah, you might write
that. You're right.
So, how can you say she ain't got no self love?
It's not she don't got no self love, but you gotta. For me, it's like.
But
you gotta stand on it. Like, stand on what you're saying for I can
that's
respect.
Listen.
You gotta stand on it, bro.
She gotta stand on it depending on how you treated her. That's what you're gonna
do. That's what I'm saying, dude.
If you done, like, dogged her, bro. Then she found out.
That's different. Like if you been, not, no listen. If you've been treating like shit the whole relationship.
But I'm saying.
And no, look, Clip. I swear to God, if you've been treating like shit this the whole relationship and you cheat on her and then she take it back, I'm like, bitch, that bitch dumb. But listen, if you don't treat her like a fucking queen and you step out
one time
it's different. It's a little like, but why? Look, it's like, why would she? Listen, bro, it's we know the world we live in. These niggas is not shit, nigga. We know that. You so right. Why go deal with a nigga?
Listen, but I'm saying though.
Why go deal with a nigga who ain't we saw talking. Why go deal with a nigga who ain't shit? But when nigga who you, listen, bro, real shit, cuz. Why tell a female to go deal with a nigga who ain't? But you got sisters. Why go tell a nigga like you know this? Why go tell you? So you tell me. Listen, Cliff.
You gotta think.
Cliff, listen. Let me finish. Okay, he stepped out. But she go to a next nigga who might not cheat, but he beating on her. She calling him every day. She black eyed the fuck.
That's a stretch scenario.
It's not a stretch. Nigga, women get beat every day.
Cuz, you gotta think. All I'm saying is this.
You know how you stop all this?
You gotta think, cuz.
Just don't do nothing.
Cuz.
You're contradicting yourself, cuz.
It's not contradicting. Okay, say I cheat. I got a girlfriend.
I feel like beating on a woman is worse than cheating on her. On God.
Because it's literally the same thing. One is physical abuse and one is mental abuse.
I feel like
obviously punching you in your face is worse physically.
Be on the word. That's what I'm saying. As a man, the same thing.
You gotta think.
Bro, okay, listen, Cliff. You can go to jail for being on him. You can't go to jail for cheating on him.
You gotta think. Them wounds gonna heal though. Physically.
Oh my god.
Them mentally gonna be on her forever.
When you physically beat a woman, you mentally hurt her too. How you gonna Cliff? So if I tell if I tell a woman I love her, I'm gonna protect her, and I go the next day and beat on her ass, that's mentally fucking her.
You gotta think, cuz say you beat a bitch one time, you slap her one time, but you done cheat on her 3-4 times. Which one hurt more?
Be slapping her probably.
It's totally different. We talking about
thank you, Deuce. Please get this.
Physically beating a woman.
Physically
bro,
beating a woman is the worst. Yeah.
Look, obviously, it's worse than beating her.
Listen.
Okay, so what are you saying?
If y'all young too, she gonna think this how love.
This is exactly you gonna scar for life.
On broke her.
So you don't think cheating is scarring somebody for life,
bro? Yes, but you you not understanding. She'll be getting beat on for the rest of her fucking life.
She gonna think this is how love person cut. It's like if a woman grew up in a household where they argue all the time, exactly. They fight.
They gonna think that's natural. Sure. Nigga, you seen it firsthand, motherfucker. Nigga, both of y'all have seen it. Bro, hell no. Nah, Cliff, fuck that. Cause you seen it firsthand. What the fuck? A battered woman.
A lot of women are gonna get behind what I'm saying.
No,
they understand
not.
What I'm saying.
Really,
I'm telling
listen,
you, girl.
Listen, on my dead.
It just depends.
On my
dead.
A man putting his hands. A man putting his hands on a woman
is the worst thing a man could do.
Bro,
which one happens more?
I don't think no second chance.
Cheating or beating happens more.
Actually, beating on people happens more.
No fucking way. You think so?
No, he right.
You think somebody's
bro? Oh God, bro. Yes, bro. Bro, on God, I watch a chick talk.
What's the question again?
He said, "What happens more?
You think
beating on a female or cheating
on or cheated on more? Be real.
They getting cheated on more,
bro. They're getting bro. It's about the same level. They get. It's about the same amount. Cuh." Physical abuse, bro. On God, if I was watching TikTok today, I swear to God. But a girl said, he was like, "What's the toxic thing that you like?" She said, "I like when a nigga beat on me a little bit."
But
I promise you, God.
Talking in a sexy way?
No, she said.
Two different
meanings,
gang.
She said, "I swear to God." She said, "I like when he beat on me, and then we have sex after." Cause we don't argue.
They're not talking about.
She's talking about beating. Yes, she's talking about beating.
No way, bro.
Bro, we're talking about abuse. I was trying to show you a fucking video, bro.
Bro, we know the difference between abuse.
First of all,
and motherfucking.
What you mean?
And me slapping you like bitch, tighten up.
That's abuse. What the fuck?
No abuse,
Cliff. Deuce. So if I come slap you right now, is that assault or not?
That's we're talking about two men.
It's two.
It's two totally different
things. We don't fight.
I don't say, bro.
But I'm still assaulting you. So if I go slap. But if I go slap a woman right now, nigga, that's abuse, nigga. That's not no fucking
ass. But that's been my opinion, though. I've been saying I don't want my woman to take me back after I step out on her. I wouldn't respect that. I've been saying.
So you would respect her if you beat on her?
Huh? No. No,
let's move on, bro.
That's not something new, though. I've been saying that. I would not want my woman to take me back after
Cliff,
I stepped out.
So you telling me.
Basically, if you step out on her, that means it's something.
I wouldn't.
If you put your hand on her, that means it's something. It's the same thing.
Bro, but why?
You said, bro, you literally just said, you said it's the same thing. Me, you said, I'm physical hurting her. Nigga, when you beat on a woman, you physically and mentally fucking her. Cause ain't no telling what you done told that girl.
But if you cheat on her, you might as well hit her too. It's literally the same thing. Girl.
It's different. I'm not physically.
Okay, let's ask.
We're gonna put a poll.
Please put a poll.
We're gonna put a poll. What's worse?
Which one is worse?
Cheating or beating her? You know what?
Being abused,
getting beat up, or getting cheated on.
No,
what is gonna hurt you?
Being abused or being mentally abused. Which one do you think is worse?
Over first of all, time, when you get physically abused, it's still the same thing as mentally abused.
We gotta think.
Listen. Okay, look. Well, I'm gonna tell you the pros and cons, right? And we shouldn't even talk about the pros and cons. But we're talking about pros and cons. Nigga, the pros and cons, you get. All right, look, let me put it side by side. Cheating and getting beat on, right? Cheating, physical abuse, mental abuse, physical trauma. You leaving marks, leaving scars on the ass. You mentally abusing her because you. Look. You making her feel like you making her feel like she's not worth nothing because you putting your hands on her after you done told her. Listen, after you done told her, I love you. I will never hurt you. I'm your protector. As a let me finish. I'm giving you the proof.
Okay.
I cheat on her.
It's the same thing.
I mentally fucked her.
Besides the bruises, it's
not
the
one
same
time.
Thing.
Not one time I put my hands on her. None of that shit. Right? If I cheat on her, she is gonna hurt her mentally. Yes, it's gonna make her feel like damn, like what I did for this nigga to do. Let me finish. What I did.
Okay.
What I did for this nigga to do that. But if I punch her in the face and say, bitch, I love you after, she be like, how the fuck can you love me and you just beat on me?
Good. It's the same thing without the abuse.
I don't think y'all ever gonna agree with this.
No, that's always been my opinion, though.
Bro, I'm telling you, bro.
I personally, I would not want my woman to take me back.
Both is wrong. Let's get this out there. Both is wrong.
Completely wrong.
But I feel like you can come back from cheating. You can't come back from putting your hands on that.
Niggas have came back from beating a bitch multiple times.
But because they have no self-love. We going back to the self-love thing you just said. They have no self-love.
Listen, cuz.
And like what I said at the beginning.
Let him finish.
Cliff.
He just said what
you
I just said.
You got a daughter, right? You got a daughter.
Bro, I'm telling you, bro. Would you rather your daughter come home? Listen, dad, would you rather your daughter come to the house and tell you a nigga done cheated on her, a nigga done beat on her?
Which one?
Because you're going to jail at that point if he beat on her.
It's the same thing. It's the same thing.
Oh, my God.
Bro, on God, bro.
Y'all are literally taking it.
No, we're not taking it. We're putting in a scenario to what you're saying. Listen, on God, I'd rather my daughter. Listen.
So you saying they equal.
Bro, if you're saying that equal, you're saying that equal. Mentally, if you're saying, okay, I just,
bro,
I
it's not equal,
somebody.
Bro. I know, but listen, we all done been through things mentally, right? I know I could get over somebody cheating on me more than I get over somebody beating on me. On God. And that's gonna always be in my head to what, when a bitch tell me she love me, bitch, you done slapped me before. You don't really love me. What the fuck?
Yeah. Saying cheating is
you
not
can't mistakenly punch somebody in the face. That's what I'm saying.
You can't mistakenly cheat.
You can't mistakenly cheat, but you could come back from cheating to where you can't cheat. You won't cheat no more. Once you learn, once the person show you they ain't fucking with you no more, after you done cheated, you'll learn. Boy, goddamn.
But let's just put it in the same group, though. Cheating and abuse need to be in the same exact group.
It's both fucked up. Yes, I'm telling you. But
we're going back to
the self-love thing. All I'm going back to what you said about self-love. I feel like you said a woman, if you said you feel like if your woman take you back to CCU, she had no self-love.
And I've been told you that.
Yeah, but I'm saying,
the reason why they different, same but different, because one of them you can go to prison for, the other one,
exactly,
you can't. To make it make sense.
Okay, but y'all are thinking as literal, like me hitting her physically.
What are we talking about?
Honestly, if I hit her,
I know. I'm agreeing.
You get what I'm saying? Like it's the same thing. Trauma is the same thing. But obviously, if I'm hitting you, obviously gonna hurt.
Okay then.
Beat her, but trauma
mentally, bro. Mentally, you could get over something like that.
Which one is more common?
Physical being, bro.
I don't know people.
Bitches is getting beat every
day.
They
might not tell y'all that shit, but you don't know what going behind closed doors. We're not in everybody's relationship.
That's true.
We're not.
Bro, bitches are not getting beat. Bro, people are getting cheated on more than they're getting beat.
Fucking God. Bro, you lucky this fucking camera on me, bro. On my fucking mama, bro. Boy, because, bro.
God, I can
God. Deuce. Do you hear this, kid?
God, you think bitches getting beat?
Bitch, you live with me.
God,
and you say what? What did you say? What did you say? Deuce, he live with me. What did he say?
Deuce.
Huh? He's thinking of it as
I know.
He know what I'm trying to say.
You gotta have an open eye. I'm with you, and I'm with you.
I'm telling you, it's the same thing.
You can't
bro.
Tell me girls out here getting beaten. Stand,
no fucking
bro.
Way.
There's no
way,
bro. They're staying. And getting beat. Come on.
Bro, all right, Cliff.
Alright, bro.
I guess these niggas don't. I guess they don't.
Nah, it's.
I guess they don't.
I don't put my hands on women.
I guess y'all haven't. Remember? Y'all have no memory?
God, dude.
Y'all mind gone?
We talking about the average.
No, that's cause and effect. If we being real, that's cause and effect.
Like, how?
We done talked about this shit for hours.
But okay, I'm glad you just said that. I'm glad you said cause and effect. I don't give a fuck what the fuck somebody do to you that does not mean you put their hands on them. On God.
I've been saying
okay
that,
then.
But I'm saying
okay
I
then.
Understand.
That goes back to your self-love topic, motherfucker. The fuck can somebody, you fuck up, you make a mistake. Nigga, you ain't even fucking cheat. If you want to be real.
Okay.
You ain't even cheat. And a woman think you did something, now she got the right to put her hands on you. Nigga, that's physical abuse. That hurt me worse than a motherfucker cheating on me. On God. End of the fucking podcast.
I ain't gonna lie. He done talked me that day, cause I ain't gonna lie. We done had talks, cause.
I'm telling you.
He was like, man, I ain't gonna lie, bro. That shit back in my head, bro.
It literally depends,
thank you.
Bro.
Thank you.
Bro, a lot Cliff, of women don't
God,
get behind
no.
what I'm saying.
On God. I'm gonna put it where nobody knew. Remember when I told you about that, what happened with the thing? And I don't even try to talk about it. But what do I talk about the most? When I talk about that. Come on, bro. So it affect me more than that. Dude,
but that never happened, though. The one I'm talking about never happened. That's something you don't have to worry about.
But still, I'm talking about
God, you're not thinking what I'm talking about.
Bro, we on the same page, but we not, bro. Like we
you think of as a physical.
We're never gonna get
I never
it. Bro, listen, it physically hurt me and it mentally hurt me to where I still think about it every fucking day.
But you gotta think that situation was only physical. You get what I'm saying? Come on, nah. If somebody is cheating on you multiple times and somebody beats you one time, which one is worse?
Of course, you putting numbers in it now. Yeah, we're talking about one and one.
One and one.
We're talking about one and one.
One and one, now. One and one.
One and one.
You got to think.
One and one.
Which one would you rather hurt? Be hurt mentally or physically?
I'd rather be hurt physically. Mentally.
No, physically.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't rather nobody beat me up.
I play football.
But I'm saying, it's different from when it's coming from somebody you love, bro.
Because if you hurt by if you hurt by somebody you love, mentally it's gonna fuck you up. So I'd rather them as a man.
It really depends, bro.
You know, like, as a man, bro, if a bitch swing on you, bro, she gotta be crazy over you. The other way around. I ain't gonna lie, but
I feel like if a woman swings on you, she have no respect for you.
Bro.
Just like I would have no respect for a woman if I sit here and punch her in the face, she don't have respect for you hitting on you.
So basically, see, I'm with him. When the roles switch, it's too different. If you're a woman, bro, and you're putting your hands on your man, bro, it depends, bro. It depends. It depends, bro.
Bro, bitches is not just waking up beating a nigga, bro.
I'm saying.
Not just out the blue.
Bro.
Bitches do not wake up and be like,
bro,
oh my
you
god.
You can't lie, bro. It do depends, bro. If a woman, bro, some women get like, it's in a certain way. It's in a certain way. As a man, bro.
A female is not waking up in the morning. Oh, ain't no juice in the fridge. I'm gonna go hit my nigga. Bro, no,
We gotta go.
Man, we love y'all. We appreciate y'all tuning in, bro. KK Right Podcast, a man's mental. As you see, we got extremely off fucking topic. Cause these niggas wanna get on topics that they know I go hard about. You feel me? So, bro. But KR Podcast, man, tune in next week. Not this. Tune in this Wednesday. Yo. To watch this shit. But tune in next week for the part 2. Cause we gonna hit on this shit again. And we love y'all. We out.
Cool.
Y'all got me fucked up, man.
Bro, you would take it. I'm saying.